Welcome back to the second session of biography. It is not how much we do, but how much love we put in the doing. It is not how much we give, but how much love we put in the giving. These words were said by Mother Teresa. Mother Teresa was a Roman Catholic nun. She devoted her life to serve the poor and needy all around the world. She spent many years in Calcutta, India, where she founded the Missionaries of Charity, a religious congregation devoted to help those in great need. We all must have heard about Mother Teresa, right? In 1979, Mother Teresa was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize and became a symbol of charitable, selfless work. In 2016, Mother Teresa was canonized by the Roman Catholic Church as Saint Teresa. Let's move on to history of Mother Teresa. She was born in 1910 in Skopje, the capital of Republic of Macedonia. Little is known about her early life, but at a young age, she felt a calling to be a nun and serve through helping the people. At the age of 18, she was given permission to join a group of nuns in Ireland. After a few months of training with the Sisters of Loreto, she was then given permission to travel to India. She took her formal religious vows in 1931 and chose to be named after Saint Teresa of Lisieux, the patron saint of missionaries. On her arrival in India, she began her work as a teacher. However, the widespread poverty of Calcutta made a deep impression on her, and this led to her starting a new order called the Missionaries of Charity. The primary objective of this mission was to look after people who nobody else was ready to look after. Mother Teresa felt that serving others was a fundamental principle of the teachings of Jesus Christ. She often stated the sayings of Jesus, "Whatever you do to the least of my brethren, you do it to me." As Mother Teresa said herself, love cannot remain by itself. It has no meaning. Love has to be put into action, and that action is service. In 1948, she left the convent to live full-time among the poorest of Calcutta. She chose to wear a white Indian sari with a blue border out of respect for the traditional Indian dress. For many years, Mother Teresa and a small band of fellow nuns survived on minimal income and food, often having to beg for funds. But slowly her efforts with the poorest were noted and appreciated by the local community and Indian politicians. In 1952, she opened her first home for the dying, which allowed people to die with dignity. Mother Teresa often spent time with those who were dying. Some have criticized the lack of proper medical attention and their refusal to give painkillers. Others say that it afforded many neglected people the opportunity to die knowing that someone cared. Her work spread around the world. By 2013, there were 700 missions operating in over 130 countries. The scope of their work also expanded to include orphanages and hospices for those with terminal illnesses. Not all of us can do great things, but we can do small things with great love. This is words were said by Mother Teresa. She never sought to convert those of another faith. Those in our hospitals were given the religious rites and appropriate to their faith. However, she had a very firm Catholic faith and took a strict line on abortion, the death penalty and divorce, even if her position was unpopular. In 1960s, the life of Mother Teresa was brought to wider public attention by Malcolm Muggeridge, who wrote a book and produced a documentary called Something Beautiful for God. In 1979, she was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize for work undertaken in the struggle to overcome poverty and distress, which also constitutes a threat to peace. She didn't attend the ceremonial banquet, but asked that the $1,92,000 fund be given to the poor. In later years, she was more active in Western developed countries. She commented that though the West was materially prosperous, there was often a spiritual poverty. When she was asked how to promote world peace, she replied, "Go home and love your family." Over the last two decades of her life, Mother Teresa suffered various health problems, but nothing could stop her from fulfilling her mission of serving the poor and needy. Until her very last illness, she was active in traveling around the world to the different branches of the missionaries of charity. During her last few years, she met Princess Diana in the Bronx, New York. The two died within a week of each other. Mother Teresa was a living saint who offered a great example and inspiration to the world. The hunger for love is much more difficult to remove than the hunger for bread. That's all about Mother Teresa. Now we'll see in another session. Bye. Thank you.